Sensational poulet, le perfect way. Cooking perfection on Ireland AM. Brought to you by the Dietrich.
Welcome back. It's Sunday morning and many people will be heading out for a brunch today, but we're making our own and you can too.
Well, we say we're. We have a new chef in the kitchen today, Shane Rigney from Riggers D8. There in Dublin 8, funnily enough, joins us. Good morning, Riggers.
How are you?
Shane,
we've known
very well.
A couple of hours now, we're on that level, Riggers.
Yeah.
What we make, we're making a really classic brunch.
We are, so we're doing a croque madame. So the reason I wanted to do this was it's really simple. I call it like a posh ham and cheese sandwich, but it is elevated.
So people will be familiar with a croque monsieur, which, as you say, is a posh grilled ham and cheese sandwich.
Ham and cheese sandwich, yeah.
With a sauce,
A bechamel
sauce.
What's the
difference with the madame?
The madame just has an egg on top, a fried egg.
Right.
Egg on top. Right, and we're going to posh this up, because we can all make a ham and cheese toast at home, but this is, there's a certain finesse to this and key ingredients that make it different.
Yeah, so, I mean, like, for me, this is just a brilliant brunch dish because, particularly to do at home, you know, because you're not like poaching eggs.
Yeah.
You're not making different sauces. You're not, you know.
People might be scared of the bechamel, though. So, being able to see the.
Yeah, the bechamel is easy.
So, why don't you start with
the bechamel? So, your bechamel is a basic white sauce, like a French white sauce, and you can add cheese to it, and then it turns it into something else. So, you start with about 75 grams of butter.
Okay.
So, you just pop that into the pan, pot, whatever, and let that melt.
Okay.
You don't want that to. Cook out too much because if it becomes brown, then it's kind of nutty, and that's not the flavour you want.
We don't want a burn noisette.
We don't want a burn noisette, no, exactly.
Huh? No, we don't.
A burn noisette.
So you just want it to kind of like melt away, and then you'll start to see it foam. Once it's foaming, you're in a good place. If you don't have it on too high a heat, it's not going to burn.
Cool.
You can still see plenty of butter that's not melted yet, so that's going to keep the temperature down. If it's on a really high heat, it'll just melt and burn really quick, and you don't want that brown butter.
So that we add what?
Yeah. So at that stage, you can add the same amount of flour.
Plain flour.
So it's plain flour. You can use self-raising flour, but you know. Plain flour, you know, but any flour you have.
And the same quantity, so 75 grams of butter,
75 grams of butter and 75 grams of flour. And you just really want to cook the flour out. I mean, a lot of people would probably be familiar with this kind of a sauce, you know.
Yeah.
It's a roux. And then can you make stews out of this, you know, obviously as a base.
Lasagna.
Lasagna, you know.
It's your white sauce for your lasagna.
It's your white sauce for your lasagna, yeah. So just cook the flour out slightly, incorporate it fully with the butter.
And people haven't cooked this before. People would tend to panic at this stage because you think, well, it's clumpy.
It's getting lumpy.
No, no, no.
It's all good. This is what you want.
Yeah, it will be clumpy.
Cook out the flour.
When you put the flour in. But as you start to cook it out, you'll see around the edges there.
Yeah.
It's becoming more paste-like.
Beautiful.
And smooth. And again, you can go with that for a while, about a minute.
Mm. Yes.
But, you know, if you're used to doing it, you've done it once or twice, you can throw the milk in, and that'll start to do it as well, you know?
And then the milk. Quantity on that?
So the milk could be about 200 mils.
Okay.
But it depends how thick you like it, really, do you know?
Okay.
Like a lot of white sauces can be really loose. I find that they drip too much over the bread,
and then
it becomes too soggy.
You want it to be claggy. Okay.
So you let that cook out. We can pop up the heat on that now.
And again, you don't want to be afraid of lumps here. They will cook out.
They will cook out.
That sauce moving.
It'd be handy if I had a whisk, but I brought a spoon, so that's kind of
doing the job.
That's easy, you know.
That's what they used before they had whisks.
But a whisk is fine. So you'll see it will start to cook out. Now, that is basically your white sauce once it's cooked out. Now that will get thicker and thicker and thicker. So even though it looked like I added a good splash of milk in there, you see it's becoming quite thick, it's gone. So you'll do another bit. So again, in total to 75 and 75 flour and
200.
Butter, about 200.
Okay.
Yeah.
And could you, if you wanted, or I don't know whether you do, would you add a little spice in there? Could you add a nutmeg or something?
A little bit of nutmeg. I personally don't like it. I find it a little bit soapy. And for this, I don't want any kind of distraction. This is just about good bread, really good quality ingredients, really nice free-range eggs, good ham, loads of cheese. I don't want to taste nutmeg.
Right. Gotcha. You don't want a soapy sample.
Keep it simple.
Yeah, keep it simple.
All right.
So that would cook away there, right? So that's your sauce. That's what people would do. A lot of times when you're making this, traditionally, to French recipes, this is kind of a little bit Irishy, an Irishy-ized version, as in we're going to mix up the cheeses. You can spread some mustard, whole grain, or Dijon onto the bread, but I kind of tend to just put it in.
All right,
you know,
okay,
then it just kind of adds more flavour to the sauce.
Nice, yeah.
So it's a tablespoon of
each. You're going for a whole grain mustard.
Whole grain and Dijon.
And a Dijon.
Yeah, I like it quite mustardy. Again,
nice.
Purists might say it shouldn't be mustardy,
That'll kick against the creaminess of the sauce.
It's lovely. Yeah, I just think it's really nice. So, you know.
No, I'd be a fan of the mustard.
Oh, yeah.
More than that.
And the mustard tends to season it enough.
Yeah.
You know, and obviously you've got salted butter. So you can add a little pinch of salt in that. But I think it's fine as it is. Mm-hmm. So you can see the way that's coming up to a really nice thick sauce, right? Yeah. It's quite yellow.
Yeah.
So needs a bit more milk.
Okay.
You know?
Okay, so that's an indicator.
Yeah.
As well, that you
I mean, if you're using mustard and it's quite yellow, you might want to put another little bit of milk into it so it's not so mustardy. But that's your basic sauce. That's going to just cook away there.
Okay, so that's fabulous.
Yeah, so that's we're going to use that to assemble it. So, excuse me. So you have another pan on, and you don't have to do it this way. You can start to assemble the sandwich and grill it. Mm-hmm. So obviously you want melted cheese on top.
Yeah.
But I like to just toast the bread on the pan so that you're you don't have a soggy bottom.
Okay.
You know. So a little bit of butter into the pan.
And the bread, you're using a sourdough.
I'm using a sourdough. So, again, this is not going to work with something like a sliced pan.
No.
It's not. You have to have good bread.
Okay.
Sourdough has been fermented, so it's nice and chewy. The gluten has been worked out, so it's strong.
Mm.
So a country loaf or something like that, if you don't have sourdough, because a lot of people find it hard to kind of get a good sourdough.
Yes. Mm. Yeah.
So, again, another pan, butter's melting. Just put their two slices of bread in. So you have your bottom and your lid.
Okay.
Yeah? So... this is basically the bechamel with the mustard that I already have.
Okay.
So that will kind of, as it cools, kind of solidify and it becomes like a paste. So you can just do this on your board once your bread is kind of toasted.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, pop it back on to your grill pan.
And you toast both sides of the bread or just one?
I just toast one side because this is going to grill. You know, and if you toast the two sides first and then cook the sandwich, it might go too crispy.
Okay.
And your cheese will go hard.
So
and,
don't be afraid of the sauce. Get loads in there.
Loads of salt. Well, I put loads on.
Great.
Sometimes it's just a smear, but loads on.
You'll do well here, my friend. You
So the ham, then, is the component, obviously. That's the lovely salty savouriness.
What kind of ham have you gone for?
A couple of nice big slices of ham, right? Now, this is not...
Is that a smoked ham, Anthony?
It's a smoked, like a Black Forest ham. You can use baked ham that's not cured, but I think a really nice Black Forest ham goes really, really well with it.
Gotcha.
Okay.
So then, again, cheese. Traditionally, so the bechamel you can see now is...
Done.
Tickling up.
Basically done, yeah.
Okay.
So cheese now. So this is the Irish part. So Gruyere cheese is what traditionally goes on a croque madame.
Yeah.
Classic French cheese.
Yeah.
Good melting point.
As they say.
Great melter, yeah. I put a little bit of Irish cheddar, a good Irish cheddar.
Best cheese.
This is a Knockanore, which I love.
Okay, so you're just strengthening the flavour?
I think the cheddar just adds a little bit of sharpness to it.
Okay. Yeah.
So the Gruyere is like kind of nutty
and you've
mellow.
A bit of orange.
And then a little bit of red cheddar and some mozzarella.
The more the merrier.
The more the merrier, right? So that's it. So you want to just get that
breakfast, baby.
Into the...
So you're grilling that.
So then you grill that, right?
Okay.
So that just goes under the grill, right?
And then
we want... The next part is our egg.
Right.
So we have
How long
here.
Are you going to grill that for?
You'll grill that for about... It's literally cooked. It's kind of cooked out. Like, your sauce is already cooked. You've cooked
you
out your bechamel.
Melt cheese.
You just want to melt the cheese.
Oh.
So there's one coming straight out of the oven. So that's what it looks like. So I'll just pop that there. Okay.
Yeah, we're kind of killed for time here on the egg.
Okay, so we'll crack the egg
in. So basically, just going to fry an egg and
fry
pop
an
it on
egg
top.
And pop it on top.
And whatever way you like the egg, but maybe
whatever way
a
you like
bit
the egg, but it should be runny.
And if you wanted, you could do a poached egg, I'd imagine, as well.
No.
Don't do a poached egg.
That would be sacrilege.
Riggers has told you.
It has to be a fried egg, right?
Sacre bleu.
So you have to...
No poached egg on this sandwich.
No poached egg. So you want to fry an egg.
Nice and simple.
So that's going to take it.
So that's basically the croque monsieur. And this makes it the croque madame.
Voilà.
Yeah.
Right, we're going to taste that. You'll see the finished product in about 3 minutes if there's anything left. Good job, Riggers. Well done.
Yeah,
thank you.
Riggers, well done, mate.
Thanks
for Riggers in D8. Check it out now. Up next, we are recreating the style of the Duchess of Cambridge. Hope there's a cardigan. We're up on the catwalk next. That caught me out well then, guys.